Hey there, instead of using z-scores to find the area under a curve, we're now going to be given the area under the curve and we have to find the z-score that goes with that corresponding area. So we're going to draw a bell-shaped curve and identify the region under the curve that corresponds to the given probability. Once again, we'll really focus on drawing a picture for every single question. And then using the cumulative area to the left, so using the area to the left of that unknown data value we're trying to find, we'll use our table to identify the data value that gives that probability the best. So we'll find the closest probability in the body of the normal probability table. And then I'll show you how to use technology. So the probability table is just for you to understand how things used to be done and how some people still do stuff. Using the same bone density test as our previous video, find the bone density score that separates the bottom 2.5% and find the score that separates the top 2.5%. In my picture, my mean is 0 because I'm dealing with the standard normal distribution. And I'm looking for the data value that separates the bottom 2.5%. So that means I have a region in the lower tail of the graph on the left side of the graph with the area of 0.025. And then I have another data value, another z-score, that separates an upper region of 0.025. So those regions represent the probabilities of the data values that are the top 2.5% and the bottom 2.5%. All right, so the key ingredients that we need here, I use subscript z sub 1, z sub 2, just because I'm looking for two z-scores. So let's talk about the first z-score. To find the first z-score, to find that first data value, I need to find its area to the left. So the area to the left of my first z-score, z sub 1, is 0.025. So you look at the body of your table and look for 0.025. So let's look for 0.025 in the body of our table. I am looking for 0.025. Right here at the very bottom, I have 0.025. And you see you got negative 1.9. The second decimal place is 6, negative 1.96. So my first data value is negative 1.96. What about the second data value? You have to know the area to the left. To find any data value along the bottom, along the x-axis, you must know the area to the left of the unknown data value you're trying to find. Well, we have a problem. I only know the area to the right. What is the area to the left? Well, if you know the entire area under the curve is 1, the area to the left will be 1 minus 0.025. 1 minus the area to the right. So 0.975. So you look for that in your table. Now, using common sense here, my mean of my standard normal distribution is 0, and my z sub 2 is to the right of 0, so it should be a positive number. All right, so we're going to look at our table of positive values, positive z-scores, and I'm looking for 0.975. So look in the body of the table till you find 0.975. Found it, and that's 1.96. That's 1.96. So you found your two data values. So we can use area under a curve to find data values. It's important you note that you must know the area to the left of the data value you are finding. So using these tables is a lot of work. Assume the thermometer readings are normally distributed with a mean of 0 degrees Celsius and a standard deviation of 1 degree Celsius. Find a temperature reading corresponding to P sub 85. That means the 85th percentile, in case you forgot that notation. It's the temperature which separates the bottom 85% from the top 15%. So think about your picture. I have 0. Right in the middle, that's my mean, and I'm looking for the data value that separates the bottom 85% from the top 15%. So I'm looking for the z-score, or the data value, that has an area to the left of 0.85 and an area to the right of 0.15. Remember, to find a data value, you always have to know area to the left. So, I'm going to introduce you to Google Sheets here, because using the table is tiring. In Google Sheets, your mu will be equal to 0, the sigma will be equal to 1. When you're trying to find data values from probabilities or from areas, the only other thing you have to type into your sheet is the area to the left. The area to the left of the data value I'm trying to find is 0.85. Use your picture to your advantage. So let's show you how to use Google Sheets now. So in Google Sheets, we'll go to our Compute tab, and we're focused on the normal region. So mu is 0 and sigma is 1. You don't care about anything else except the left tail area. When you're trying to find data values, you use left tail area. Well, it's 0.85. So the corresponding data value, we'll do two decimal places for data values, is 1.04. 1.04 after you round. That's 1.04. So my data value is 1.04. How about that? So the area to the left is key. To the left, to the left. We use the area to the left. So using Google Sheets is so much fun. Let's do some more practice. So assume that thermometer readings are normally distributed with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1 degrees Celsius. Assume 2.8% of thermometers are rejected because they have readings that are too high. And there's another 2.8% of the thermometers rejected because their readings are too low. So these are thermometers that just are terrible at reading the temperature. We need to throw them out. Quality control stepping in here. Find the cutoff values which separate the rejected thermometers from the others. So standard normal means my mean in the middle is 0. So I'm finding the data value that cuts off the bottom region of 0.028, that's 2.8%, and I'm trying to find the other data value that cuts off the upper region with an area of 0.028. Alright, so I'm looking for two values. We'll just label them Z1 and Z2. Let's use Google Sheets. So Google Sheets, mu is 0 and sigma is 1. We're trying to find Z1 first, that smaller cutoff value. And my area to the left, as shown in my curve, remember always draw that picture, is 0.028. This is going to help us find what is Z1. Now, what about Z2? Well, we know that mu is equal to 0 still. This doesn't change when you're dealing with standard normal data. Sigma is 1, and the area to the left, we don't know. Uh-oh, we have an issue. Well, remember how to find area to the left. It's 1 minus the area to the right. 1 minus 0.028. Subtract that right-hand area from 1. So 1 minus 0.028 will actually give you, in this case, 0.972. And that's going to tell me what Z2 is, that upper cutoff value. Alright, so what's going to happen here is, let's type all this information into Google Sheets. We have two separate things we'll be typing in. So Google Sheets to the rescue. Mu and sigma are already 0 and 1, so my left tail area for my lower cutoff value is going to be, alright, so left tail area is 0.028. You get negative 1.91. And then the left tail area for my larger cutoff value will be 0.972. The area to the left is 0.972. What? It's positive 1.91. How could this be? It's the same number, just the negative version and the positive version. Why is that? Well, first let's write down our answer, then we can talk about that, right? So Z sub 1 is negative 1.91. That's your lower cutoff value. And Z sub 2 is positive 1.91. That's your upper cutoff value. And the reason why they are the same number, just one's positive, one's negative, is because our two tails on either side of the curve both had an area of 0.028, and then our mean of a standard normal distribution is 0. So because of that symmetry, that's why you have negative 1.91, positive 1.91. 0 in the middle, same area on both tails, the values will be opposites of each other. All right, so that is how to find data values using area under a curve. Thanks for watching.